Hello, I'm Vanya Kröger, also known as Nechtan. The following video is taken straight from the Nechtan Drum School. Many of you will probably remember the old strange double bass foot technique explained video on my channel, which was uploaded many years ago and which has by now almost 2 million views. This tutorial is a newer and much better version of that video. So, if you are interested in the Nechtan Drum School, click the link below this video. There you will not only find the follow-up tutorials to this video, but also many more tutorials, tons of play-along exercises, and there you will also get personal support. And now, have fun with the tutorial. Hello and welcome to this chapter in which we will learn the advanced double bass drumming technique of heel-toe single strokes. Enjoy! This is kind of an alternative path to learning ankle motion, and either you can stay with heel-toe single strokes or later easily switch to double strokes from here. Heel-toe single strokes is my main technique when it comes to playing fast, and although it is a lot less common than ankle motion, it is in no way inferior. It is harder to learn playing complex patterns with it, but it is easier to develop good stamina with this technique compared to ankle motion. So, let us start with a description of the basic motion. First of all, this is neither a heel up nor a heel down technique, since we constantly switch between these two. Let us start by taking a look at just our right foot. We begin, like with the full leg motion, by lifting up our leg and dropping it down on the pedal. But other than with full leg, our heel does not stay above the ground, but instead we push it down all the way. So we don't completely lock the ankle, but instead let it loose the moment we hit the bass drum, like this. When we have arrived with our heel down, we are in a perfect position to make a simple heel down hit like this. But we do it with more power so that our heel is pushed up again like this. And just like this, we are back at where we started and can continue with another full leg hit. So although the name heel toe kind of suggests it, we are not actually hitting the pedal with heel and toe, but we alternate between full leg motion and heel down ankle motion. But since full leg motion slash heel down ankle motion hybrid double bass drum technique is a rather impractical term, let us just stick with heel toe single strokes. So, where shall we begin? First of all, and before we start, we should check our pedal settings. Same as for full leg motion, I recommend to start with low or medium spring tension. And as always, I recommend to have both pedals set up symmetrically and similar to each other. It is also very, very important to have both beaters far enough away from the bass drum head. If they are too close, it will be almost impossible to utilize this nice natural backswing of our pedals. We will start step by step and with only one foot at a time, because this technique is not very intuitive to learn, and we have to be comfortable with each foot individually before we start combining them both. In the beginning, we don't need a metronome. We will just start by very slowly practice the isolated movements. Downstroke, upstroke, downstroke, upstroke. Just like this. The position on the pedal doesn't matter too much right now. Usually it is easier in the beginning to start with your foot high on the pedal, like this. Try to hit the upstroke with a lot of power from your ankle, because later we want both of them, upstroke and downstroke, to have an equal volume, and the upstroke tends to be weaker. You can also try starting with the upstroke first, like this. Take your time and practice with your left foot at least as much as with your right. Concentrate on making big movements and loud impacts. If you don't have access to your drum set often enough, you can also do an away from kit exercise. Just sit down wherever you like, sit on the edge so your legs have free movement, and then lift your right leg up like this. Now let it fall to the floor with the ball of your foot hitting the floor slightly before the heel comes down. Just like this. Next, make a simple heel down hit like this. But push further until your heel comes up again like this. And then start all over again so you get this kind of motion cycle. Repeat this exercise with your other foot. Of course, this exercise doesn't replace playing on your pedal, but it can help out in the beginning. In case your shin muscles hurt a lot, you can also do a different AFK exercise to train them, which I will call AFK exercise 2. Our heel stays on the ground and we lift our foot like this, and then just hit the ground. Just like this. We should stay relaxed in our upper leg while doing this. Let us make sure to actually hit the ground. So this would be wrong, and this is right. So let us make sure to hit the ground and also to hold one tempo for more than just seconds. When your shin muscles start hurting, you are doing it right. Of course, repeat the same with your left foot. Back to our pedals. The next step is getting a feeling for the natural momentum of the pedal and to let the whole up and down motion become one fluid cycle. For that, let us put our foot more back here. Depending on your pedal settings, there will be at one point an optimal speed where the pedal itself and the spring can do a lot of work for us and where we don't have to force the pedal into movement. On this pedal, for example, this would be around 160 bpm. You can see that I can easily keep the pedal swinging with just my little finger, and this is the effect we want to learn to utilize. So we place our foot back here, that our toes are around the middle of the pedal board. Now we use the motion we have learned, and then we get this. All energy is transferred to the pedal via the ball of our foot. And this is why it works even with our heel touching the floor and not the pedal. Try to let the beater swing back as far as you can. Try to not force it, but instead go along with the natural swing of the pedal. Imagine the pedal as your prisoner. You don't want to carry your prisoner all the way. No, you just hold him at gunpoint and give him a little nudge from time to time. And this is exactly what we want to do to our pedal. We just give it a little nudge with each hit, but most of the work is done by the pedal itself. Instead of mechanically moving from hit to hit, we now want to create one fluent cycle of motion and be as relaxed as possible. Once we have gotten used to this motion, we should be able to do this for a very long time without getting tired. When you start feeling comfortable with this, just do it as long as you want with both feet separately. At this point, it is essential to spend some time doing this. The less you have to think about what your feet are doing, the better. Just stay at a comfortable tempo and play at least a couple of minutes at a time with each of your feet. Make sure to practice at least as much with your weak side as with your strong side. For most people, their weak side, which is most commonly the left side, needs a lot more practice than the strong side. In the beginning, I often practiced twice as much with my left as with my right, and still my right side was always slightly better. Before you start, here is a brief list of things you might want to have an eye on. First, let the beta swing back as far as possible. Second, let the beta swing back equally far, no matter if you do the up or down stroke. Third, stay as relaxed as possible. Fourth, stay at a comfortable tempo. And finally, have fun! As soon as you feel comfortable enough with this technique so far to read a book while you are practicing, you are ready for the next step, which is basically doing the same, but with metronome. I highly recommend starting without metronome to find your comfortable tempo and to get the basics down before starting to play the following exercises with metronome. When you are ready for the metronome, the exercises range from 120 to 170 BPM, but you don't need to start at the lowest tempo. Instead, find out which tempo is most comfortable to play at and from there on work your way up and down. Once you have successfully completed the metronome exercises, we will start bringing both feet together. Have fun and enjoy! So, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. To make your next steps by going through some play-along exercises and also combining both feet later on, join the Nechtan Drum School now. Also, there you will get my personal support and a troubleshooting guide on this drumming technique, as well as many, many other videos. So, join now, link is down below in the description. Thank you for your support and see you there.